next speaker, the microphone is not working. Could you start, please, Professor Lazarevich?
Yes.
Microphone.
Yes, thank you. You hear me? It is not easy duty to finish so interesting holiday sessions and after 30 presenters. And it is because that I will try to talk clearly and only to present the main points of my research. At the very beginning, I would like to ask a question. What kind of education do we need in the new age or in the 21st century? Literature provides a lot of different approaches to the topic. All of them are different, but the common point for almost of all of them is that the new age calls for new priorities in education and calls for new education models. It requires rethinking of education systems. It means, in my opinion, that we should have an individual approach and on an individual level to increase freedom, independence, and to support students to become more creative, more critical, and to be a good thinker. It is not an easy task. And at the first place, I would like to draw your attention to creativity. Why is creativity so important? Creativity on the art side is very important on a national and global level for economic development of many countries. But on the other side, it is of key importance at the individual level too. And we must not forget it. It's very important. But what is the problem? We have some kind of confusion in literature because we can find more than 100 of definitions of creativity. Which one is right? But for the purpose of my research, I focus only on one definition of creativity, which is coming with new ideas and contributes for fostering creativity and entrepreneur's abilities through education. It's very important. How much is important creativity? We can find in the recent published title, Europe 2020 Strategy, and it inspires new initiatives like new skills for new jobs and the innovation Europe. But in any case, this strategy, we can find that creativity plays an important role. And our society must especially stress the importance of that. But besides creativity, freedom is also very important. We cannot forget freedom when we are talking about education. Because freedom in and learning has been closely connected through history, you can find it in theory or philosophy and other sciences. Within Western tradition, since a long period of time, since of the time of old Greeks, but. In an academic freedom invites that inspires namely freedom for students, freedom for faculties to express their opinion, their ideas to share with other students within a scholarly community. And also to empower their creative and entrepreneur abilities through education and raising these abilities after graduation. But when we are talking about freedom, we cannot forget to talk and to make a close connection with individuality. Because freedom is the essence of individuality, and if we have more freedom in education, We shall have more creative thinking, more original thinking. And our students can use on the better way their full potentials. But in literature, there is less research related to the factors that make an impact on entrepreneurs' abilities development through education. And it was maybe one of the reasons that I did one research, especially for our purpose, for the purpose of our conference. And the main goal of my research was firstly to investigate opportunities how to improve freedom in learning and individuality. In second place, what factors are most of key importance on increasing entrepreneurs' responsibilities and abilities also. And in third place, I would like to propose some new direction of education strategies for the near future, according to the key findings of my research. And therefore, I did one online survey, and I covered respondents from four countries, from China, from United States, from Nigeria, and from Serbia. Mostly my respondents are coming from Serbia. And I forgot to tell you that methodologies in qualitative in nature. I did one very, very deep interviews with them, but I, besides other questions, the most important questions were, firstly, what is the meaning for you of freedom, and what should be done to increase it? In third place, what do you think, what factor is of most importance to develop your entrepreneur's abilities? And in the fourth place, what kind of education do you prefer and do you think is the most suitable for contemporary times and world, which is changeable to many, many movements, economic and others. And my findings were very interesting. Almost all of the students from four countries, they understand that freedom is the highest degrees of independence. And that freedom allows students to express their questions, to develop their full potentials, their talents, and to share ideas with other students within and without education institution. And also my analysis that I did and that I conducted for each country separately also showed that difference among answers were very little. It is very interesting, and for me, at the first moment, wondering what happened. But why? The great number of respondents, more than 60%, share their opinion that if you like to improve freedom, to improve entrepreneurs' abilities through education, and develop them after graduation, we must promote or foster a better communication, multidimensional communications between professors and students, and also connected and also as well as connected with curriculum to the society within and without the educational system. And also innovative competencies can make a key role, because some unique ideas can be affirmative and good business environment be easy turn into some business activity. And in third place, they thought that they would like to have a new model of education, quite different that there is existing now, and that this model must be individual-centered, focused on freedom in teaching and freedom in learning. Because we cannot have a freedom in learning without freedom in teaching. That is close connected, of course. And I used the key findings and results of my research to propose some new model of education. And please, I would like to show this new model that I made. The next, yes, this I propose the new model of education. Firstly, as my respondents told and agreed that we must have individual-centered pedagogy and the individual-centered new model based on freedom on learning and teaching, as I mentioned before. And what is important, individual, we must, with this new education model, to foster individual growth. Individual growth, and it can be achieved toward promoting achievement. Also, rewarding results of our students, make selection. Make that kind of education system that can be sensitive to individual needs. We cannot make one global model which can be suitable for all of them. It is impossible. We are all different. Here we are different. But we can imagine how large gaps are between students, their talents, their interests, and so on. And because that, also you must make close connection and communication between students and professors, but in some quite different way that it was dominant in traditional approach to education. In the first place, students must be owner of their learning processes. But the professor role must be to be on coach. They must be like some kind of musician or dirigent which show direction and make some suggestion. But on the other side, here the students and their opinion, they can freely to express their inquiries, their opinion, without any kind of punishment. As educators, we can find in our environment that some professors can punish students if they disturb them during presentation, or the make questions. Sometimes we can say to them, "You ask too much." No, it is never too much. They must ask.
Could you summarize, please? Because then we are asked to be 7:30 downstairs.
Yes. And I will conclude with one question. Yes, we need an active mode of learning and teaching. It means that unique talents can turn into the some successful business practice. And they can recommend that we cannot make one education model for all times because our surroundings is changing and we must need one model which is adaptable and it's necessary a close synergy between schools, communities, governments. And without that, we cannot expect an effective model and suitable or appropriate for current changes in labor markets and in global economy. Thank you very much for your attention.